So here we are, focus on ability, and then we lie. We say first ever New Zealand screening. It's not. We were in Papua Nui last November, but we only showed one film in one school. That's because only three schools from New Zealand entered the film festival last year. This year there's 14, and who knows what can happen next year. I guess it's down to you. Why focus on ability? Where did that come from? Is it important? It is, you're right. I can tell we're going to get on well. You and I are going to run this show. I want to take you back in time, okay, to 1987. 1987, who wasn't here? Okay, but you were coming, you were on the way. It's 1987, and I'm teaching in a special education unit in a place called Penrith, which is in the western suburbs of Sydney. And I have got some of the best students you could ever have. They are just bright-eyed, bushy-tailed, good-to-go kids. And my job was to get them ready for transition from school to work. And you don't know this, but it's true. I am a brilliant teacher. And I taught those kids brilliantly. And they were great. They were made great employees. But, you know, I would see them 6 months after they left, or 12 months after they'd left, and I'd say, it's good to see you. How are you going? What are you doing? And they would say, well, we're at home. We're doing nothing. Or, and from my perspective, sometimes even worse, we're in a sheltered setting away from everybody else doing work that's not really perhaps just like the work everybody else would do. And community attitudes towards people with a disability were very different too. For example, one of the things we did was we'd go out for coffee. We were teaching some social skills, so we'd get the group and together we'd leave the TAFE, that's Technical and Further Education, it's a New Zealand equivalent of that, what's it called? Leave school, go to trade school?
Polytech.
Yep, so it's the equivalent of Polytech. We left the poly, went across the road to a coffee shop, and we'd have a cup of coffee together. But we'd not been doing that for many weeks when the owner of the coffee shop said to me, would you mind if I just had a chat with you? So I said, oh, sure, you know. And we just went over to one side and he said, look, he said, I don't want you to get me wrong. And you're welcome. But could you not bring those people with you because they're putting the other customers off? I thought that was strange because there were never any other customers. But apparently just the sight of my kids was enough to get this guy antsy. He was doing something that a lot of people do, and that's judging on appearance. And when you don't know, or you're uncertain, or you're afraid, sometimes the action is to reject. But I knew what we had to do was to focus on ability, and so I started a program that was actually designed to help students leave school and get real jobs. And we did that. We're still doing it. So we've been doing that for the best part of 27 years. However, along the way, we realized that this was going to change the world, but that we'd be in our 800 or 900s before we actually got around to reaching everybody. So we thought, there's got to be a quicker way. In 2008, we came up with this idea, focus on ability. And the reason we used that term was because, one, we wanted people to concentrate on the ability of the people that had a disability that were in the films, but also because you focus a camera. So it was sort of double clever, really. Appreciate that for me, please. So that's what we did in 2008. We started this competition, as it was then, amongst high schools. And there were a couple of reasons for that. First of all, who are the smartest people around? Year 11 and 12 students, eh? They're sharp, they're keen, they're not contaminated, they haven't picked up too many bad habits, and they brought fresh insight. And we also thought another thing that would be important is that if you're 18 today, how old will you be in 2026? See the value of an education? Well, kids down the front row here got their shoes and socks off, they're going for it. It's not long before the young men and women leaving school at 18 are the men and women that make decisions, that decide who gets the jobs, that decides how our society runs. And we wanted to influence them by getting them to concentrate on their peers that had a disability, and look for the positive things that they could take, the life lessons, the hopes, the realization of the hopes, the successes that those people were achieving. That was 2008, we had 14 entrants. 2009, we had 28. 2010, we had 56. This is like bacteria, it just kept doubling. And so this year, some of the films that you're going to see are part of the 161 films that were entered. If you watched all the films back to back and you didn't stop for sleep or food or anything else, you would still be watching them in 3 days' time. So that's a lot of encouragement, a lot of insight, and a tremendous resource for people that may be interested in different aspects of disability. But above all else, what they are is extremely entertaining. So it's a great privilege for us to be here. That's enough from me for a bit. We're going to get straight into some schools. Now, I am going to pronounce these schools wrong. Okay, it's a test. Okay, see if you can spot where I get it wrong. We've got Wairu Valley Special School. Yeah. Hey. Belmont Primary. Yeah. And absolutely no agreement about how you say Putaruru. Was I in the ballpark?
Yeah.
Go me. Ladies and gentlemen, the first three films.
Age 17 to 21. For the last 6 weeks, 6 to 8 weeks, we've been practicing drumming and dance routines with Chewy, who's a drummer.
Nice, Lauren. What we did is we took a traditional African drum rhythm called Makaru, and we incorporated that in with some dance moves that the students made up themselves.
Four, one, two, three. Well, don't worry about the feet, you do your arms. Use your arms,
man. He is an amazing guy. Funny. He teaches us different things, different cultures. We enjoy jamming with him and dancing.
We've seen a lot of progression from the very first day when they didn't know any of the routines. And over the weeks, they've had ideas and all put in their own ideas to culminate in a performance for a local dance class at a local school.
Chewy has a variety of different fans. They come from lots of different countries. Most of them in African drums. I think what Chewy teaches us will give us increased self-confidence.
One, two, topping Malangi, body sings the Mahajo Malangi. Topping Malangi, body, Mahajo Malangi.
We've gone from strength to strength over the weeks to see our students, first of all, grasping the drum rhythm, which is a little bit tricky. Doing that by using words to connect to the drum rhythm so that they can sort of associate it. Then the dance moves, there's multiple levels of ability within the group, so spending the time so that all people can get to a certain point of achievement. Then basically putting it all together as a performance piece and hopefully coming out with a great outcome for this video.
Thank you.
made up?
Yeah, it's called Richard for the Stars.
Can you show it to me, sitting down? Can you show it to me with your arms?
I can't.
The dance is hard because Chewie keeps changing his mind.
I'm using my strength at dancing to help others to learn the moves. It is intimidating at times, but everyone helps each other to improve and get better.
Video, we decided to see what it felt like to be disabled on a day-to-day basis. So we had a discussion on what kind of disability we could adopt for a day to put ourselves into the daily lives of those living with a disability. Let's meet the group.
Say hi, Brad.
Nervous about anything today?
Playing soccer at lunch.
Sports.
Playing at lunchtime.
Probably social studies in the afternoon.
Working.
I'm afraid if people will judge me since I'm not talking.
What have you found challenging so far? How have your friends or other people helped you so far?
Pushing me the whole time.
Not to like bump into things. Stuff that I like.
They did things to suit what would be good for me.
Playing games with other people.
Liking. And that's.
What have you found annoying so far?
People not asking me to come play with them for my hand.
Maths.
I wanted to ask a question and I accidentally blurted it out.
I can't move around.
Here's George Rush. Today he has tried to write with various parts of his body. Here is George trying to write with his mouth. And here is George trying to write with his toes. Here is a pattern that George has drawn with his toes. And here is his name that he has written with his toes. the wall of quotes that we have in our classroom.
Kia ora, my name is Jake Hopper. I am 14 years old and a year 9 student at Potato College. And I am blind.
Jake has got optic nerve hyperplasia, septic optic dysplasia, and nystagmus. That means he's totally blind and has no light perception at all. Jake gets 0.2 specialist teacher support from Blends. He gets teacher aid support. He uses adapted technology and adapted teaching methods. He reads and writes in fully contracted braille.
Jake's transition into our classroom was surprisingly easy. He'd been mainstreamed in his previous schools and he actually knew how our systems sort of worked in the class. The class was very welcoming and he had a lot of support from students being guided around the school. But we also had a teacher aide with Jake who helped him throughout all the things we did in our class. Well, Jake, of course, cannot see and never has seen, so his appreciation of some things that we take for granted was quite difficult for him to grasp, or concepts were quite difficult to grasp. The class reacted really well. It was a good class of kids, and they were more interested in the things that he could do rather than what he couldn't do. And he had quite a few surprises for us with his special talents. He can play music, he can sing, and he does it with a confidence that a lot of kids don't have and are actually too shy. And I actually think it's given him some gifts, being blind, and some strengths. And I think a lot of young people could actually learn a lot from Jake if they sat down and just listened to him talk about his world for 5 minutes. He'd certainly be more confident.
Hold me now, I'm 6 feet from the edge and I'm thinking maybe 6 feet is so far down.
He's a good student, he likes to come to class, he's always happy. He enjoys performing and getting involved with everyone in the class. It's not often that you find talent like that in a Year 9 student with the ability to come into a Year 10 class and keep up with the other students. Last year, as a Year 8, Jake wrote and performed his own song at the Talent Quest and he came second. It was amazing. He did really well.
In 2014, he went to space camp in America. And prior to that, he was interviewed on 7 Sharp about space camp.
I really enjoy space camp. I made heaps of friends.
In At the Matariki concert, his performance earned him a standing ovation. There was a group haka from the audience.
I will never forget, as one of the highlights of my teaching career, is seeing Jake's face as he was being rowed out in a kayak out into the estuary at Waitangi. It was excited fear. Jake is exceptional, very brave, very talented, and a very natural kid.
I enjoy coming to school. I feel like a normal kid. I don't miss out on anything. Every day I look forward to a new challenge. I hope you enjoyed my story. I know I have.
Okay, so I didn't say, and I probably should have, who sees those films? How does the festival work? Well, they're all available on our website, and about a month out from the finish of the programme, we invite everybody to vote. And Ryan, you'll have to correct me on this. How many countries? 168 people from 168 countries saw the film. So does that mean that 169 people watched them? Because I watched them too. No. On the best day, 271,000 people got onto the website. So to actually come through and succeed as most online votes requires a very New Zealand attitude, because I know something you don't, and that is that New Zealand votes as a block for New Zealand films. So when we come in the morning and we have to see that no one said anything naughty in the comments box and count up all the votes and add them and check that people aren't cheating, because sometimes people try to buy votes from a place called Bangladesh. Look it up. That's cheating too. There were tens of thousands of people voting for these films. So it's not just you, your mum and your auntie Rose. It's people around the world. And why are they doing it? Because they see in these films a celebration of success. One of the things that we most want people to succeed in is the movement from school into employment. I don't know the New Zealand figures, but it wasn't so long ago that in Australia, 3 people out of every 100 that left special education to go to work or to go into the big wide world, only 3 of those 100 people actually got jobs at the same pay rate and the same conditions as everybody else. So we had to put in a lot of effort and a lot of work. And now the number's much higher. One of the people that's been responsible for that change, I'd like to introduce to you now. She is modest, I am not. The programs that she runs are world class. They've been studied by universities. She's spoken all over the place, both in Australia and overseas, about transition to work. It's my pleasure to introduce to you Anne Goyer.
Hello, everyone. So I am normally modest, but I'm going to brag a bit today. Nova Employment is the parent organisation for Focus on Ability, the film festival. And we support people with disabilities into award wage employment within the general community. Is it the same thing? Award wage would mean that it's based on... Okay. So we have a particular interest in young people, and Focus on Ability was really created so as an engagement method right in the beginning with schools and with young people, and it helps us to build strong relationships with the schools. We work with all different types of disabilities. So we have people with intellectual disabilities, people with autism, sensory disabilities. We have people who are hearing impaired, who are deaf, who are blind, people with physical disabilities, medical disabilities as well, ADHD, anxiety, depression, bipolar, some mental illnesses as well. And that's a growing group now within high schools, that there are people who have lots of issues with their mental health. And some of those disabilities, like oppositional defiance disorder, we've got people with all different types of disabilities within the program. Some of the numbers that we work with in... we've got a number of two different programs within Nova Employment, but the one that Martin's talking about is called Transition to Work. And this year we had 194 young people. It's a two-year program. So our second years that were ready to go into work, we had 83 this year to go into work. We need to have them all in work by December the 3rd, which is our graduation day. And we've got, I think, how many more to go, Martin? 18 more to go to get into work. And these are young people who are getting their first job within the general community, and that's the goal of the program. So that's a huge challenge because you're dealing with the perceptions of society and employers as to whether or not people with a disability can add value to their workplace and whether or not they can be successful workers. So the goal of the program is a smooth transition from student to employee. And this is a really important time of life because what we find is if that gap is not closed really quickly, you get young people who sit around at home, they lose the habits of getting up, going to school, making lunch, into that kind of those, you know, those habits and those patterns. If there's too much of a gap in between, then you really have to start all over again. So one of the really important things with the program is to have good, strong connections with the schools so that there's the program. We actually work within the schools in year, for us it's year 10, year 11, year 12, so that by the time they go into the transition to work program, they know us and we know them, and then they move straight into this program. We don't want them to lose that routine and skills. But probably one of the most important things for success with a program like mine, and we're now in our 10th year, so this year is our 10th anniversary, and we've improved every year. And in the first year, we didn't have the same amounts of outcomes as we do now, as in we didn't get everybody into work by the end of the program. So we've gradually improved as we've gone through the years. But it's really about being confident as a program and believing that every regular mainstream workplace has the capacity to handle workers with disabilities. So it's approaching it from that perspective. Sometimes young people with a disability can get stuck in that training cycle. They're on another course and they're on another course, and that's because people look at them and they think, well, they're not quite right for work at the moment, they need to get more skills. Or the employers look at them and think, yeah, no, they're not quite right, so we put them in another course. But the first job is a really important job, and we want to look at the same sorts of time frames for people with a disability as for regular students. And that means that you leave school and you go into your first job in quite a short space of time. So it's really about believing that people with a disability can be in employment and then looking at the content of the program that we deliver. So we start with a triangle. And at the top of the triangle, we put Nova's staff because they're driving the bus. They're the person that's coordinating the program. And then at the bottom of the triangle, equal on either side, is the young person with a disability and the employer. And it's about bringing together the needs of the employer and the person, and they need to meet somewhere in the middle. And we use that illustration because during probation, which is when you first get a job and you've got a probationary period, you need to prove yourself to an employer, that arrow goes further across. It's more about the needs of the employer. And then as we kind of work with that young person and they get settled in work, the arrow should meet somewhere in the middle so that it's the person's needs with a disability and the employer's needs. The employer's happy to pay dollars for that person's work, and it meets the needs of that young person for meaningful work and a team that they feel that they can belong to and a workplace that values them and their contribution. So we call that the job match process. We focus on the things that there was a study that was done about 30,000 employers, and they looked at unskilled jobs, semi-skilled jobs and professional positions, and they looked at the employer's criteria for why they would look at someone going into work. And the first three things that were rated most important were motivation, appearance and presentation, and confidence. And the next ones in line were previous employment history, work-related skills, experience in the industry, previous training and qualifications. Well, all of those things our guys don't have because it's their first job. But we focus on those first three things, and pretty much everyone in our program, they desperately want to work. They just want to be given that opportunity and that chance by an employer to get a job. We focus on appearance and presentation, and we focus on building confidence. And the way that we do that is we use sort of a fairly naughty acronym. Originally, Martin told me off for this acronym, but everybody remembers it. It starts with ARSS, so it's the ARS principle. And it's about a job that's achievable, that's the A, realistic, suitable, and sustainable. So what we look at is we examine each person's young choices and we measure them against those things. We start with a few achievable areas first, and that are common to pretty much every job, things like administration, customer service, and we use work experience, loads and loads of work experience, but really supported work experience. And what we do is we get lots of feedback from the employer, so it's like the real world talking to that young person, telling them, how did you do with this, what do we feel you need to work on? And we also get feedback from the staff and then feedback from the young person themselves. So if they say, I really hate that job, then that one's out. And then we narrow down the process till we find three job choices that are us. They're achievable, realistic, suitable and sustainable for that young person. We also, because work experience can help them to develop confidence, explore their options, widen their horizons, that's really important, things that you didn't think you could do. Actually, all of a sudden, you try it and you think, actually, I love that and that suits me. Identify strengths and get real-world feedback. We involve everybody in that. And typically, you think about that would be the young person themselves, their parents, the teachers, the staff. But one we often forget that we also need to involve in the planning process would be, can anybody think who it would be? Students, yeah, students. Really important one if you're going to get into work. Employer, okay? The employer has to be part of that planning process. So it's all around having individual planning with those whole group and everybody having a say. It's about having no gaps between the process of school, then going into the program, the two-year program, and then going as quickly as possible into work. We also look at a concept by Wolfensberger, which is Wolf Wolfensberger with social role valorisation. Have any of the teachers and school heard that concept? Okay. And it's about the more that society sees a person as one of us, the more protective society is about that person. So we look at appearance and body language, the ability to meet and greet, and there's lots of practice around that stuff. So I just want to finish off with a quote. In the schools are our future workforce, our future HR managers, our future business owners, our future entrepreneurs and innovators. So focus on ability is extremely powerful because whether you're a student with a disability or a student learning about other people with disabilities, you're going to be the future workforce. So this film competition has the power to change people's perceptions, and in the future it should be really easy to get somebody with a disability into employment because a lot of it's about familiarity and believing that your workplace can accommodate a person with a disability, and they can. So I'd just like to finish off with a couple of quotes that some Australian schools did. They said, this competition is amazing. My students feel so proud to be part of it, especially when they see all the awesome competition they're up against. Thanks for such a great opportunity. That's from Mildura. And from Mount Gambier, it's been great to view the other movies too, which have connected the boys with other students and people with a disability. Keep up the good work with this festival as it's bringing a lot of community awareness and support around previously disengaged members of local communities. And that's what it's all about. So we're now going to show you three more movies. And they're all around young people. There's an international one and two local Australian ones. And they demonstrate the abilities of young people with a disability. Thanks, guys.
People say that the bumblebee should not be able to fly. According to the laws of aerodynamics, his wings are too short, his body is too big. But nobody ever told him about aerodynamics. so he doesn't know what he is and isn't capable of. Despite what everyone says, the bumblebee flies. I have autism, cerebral palsy, epilepsy, and some other things. When I was a baby, the doctor told my mom and dad that I would never be able to walk, read, write, or speak. But I can do all of that. I have done the impossible. Until now, da da da! I'd never been on a date before. I went to preschool with her, but I haven't seen her since. What do I do? Goldie was very helpful. She told me I had to show off how handsome I am. I have to show off my way with words.
Yo, yo, I'm Mr. Incredible! If you can be a better rapper than me, what, woo!
She told me that I have to show off my fashion sense. Most importantly, I have to show off my moves. Thanks to Goldie's coaching, I'm ready for my date. Paige told me on the phone that she would bring a balloon to make it easier for me to find her. What do you want to do? We could go dancing. You could go to a fancy restaurant. You could take a trip to Italy.
You wanted to go to the playground?
For once, Goldie was wrong. You don't need to find somebody perfect or be somebody perfect. You just have to find another bumblebee to fly with.
Switzerland. As you know, I'm moving to the capital city, which is in Bern, and I had a lot of trains because I like trains so much.
Welcome to the race video.
There are hoes everywhere. There are hoes in the hills and the dunes. And my feet are bare, Pete.
I just call my grandpa.
Dad, how are you?
You're next.
I just call them excuse me.
And I like, hey, this is my school. I mean, my old school. This was my old school. I had a lot of fun there.
What does a dog say?
Whoop!
Yes.
Whoop.
What does a elephant say? I think you're right. What does a whale say?
Jason, and I'm 12 years old, and my friend is Davide. We have lots of fun together, and we have been friends for about 5 years, and it has been good times. Well, it's sad that Davide is going to Europe, but it's fun for him. But we're all going to miss him. We play lots of fun on the playground. We play the game called House Game.
You want to buy some sweets? We just have to cash register.
Okay.
Okay.
Now where do you want to go now? All right, well, let's head to Woolies. We can see 3 levels high there.
Oh, and also, don't we need to book a flight for your honeymoon?
Yeah. Here you go. Thank you so much.
Don't all we right, need to buy a wedding we cake home. As well?
No, the wedding cake is getting made.
Oh.
All right, let's go home now.
Yep.
Or we go to Brisbane and Bundaberg.
Yeah, we go to Brisbane, Bundaberg.
We take the train and
yeah,
the plane.
Yeah, take the train.
We head to Sydney. We head to Batemans Bay.
Yep.
Batemans Bay.
Batemans Bay. We go to Wollongong.
Wollongong.
Oh, yeah.
We went to Moomba.
Hello, Davide. How are you? I might come to Switzerland soon to see you for a couple of weeks. In the house game. I'm a girl in the house game.
Yeah, he's a girl. He's a girl and he's got Luke. But right now because his old girl boyfriend cheated on him really badly.
Because Daray was born in 2002 and I was born in 2003. And I'm the year of the goat and Daray is the year of the horse. And year and the goat and year and the horse get on well.
Davide, I think Davide will become a train driver.
Yes, I'm going to become Davide.
Davide might do a part-time job in a restaurant because he's good at Italian cuisine.
Bang! Hello, my name is Davide and I am interviewing my favourite Kara and teacher, Zaki. First question, how long have you been looking after me?
I've been looking after Davide for 300 years.
No!
Oh.
Five!
Oh.
Incorrect!
Oh, sorry, I've been looking after Davide for 5 years.
Still, incorrect! You lose a point.
I don't want to really help.
The cat won't play.
Bye, Davide! I'll miss you so much. I'll see you when I grow up!
Georgia was about 7 months old when she was diagnosed. We knew from when she was about 4 months old she wasn't developing properly, and it took till she was about 8 months old when she had scans done and they found the damage in the brain. And we walked out of the hospital that day and said, well, let's try and see what we can do. Because all you're told a lot of negative things. You're not told anything very positive. I guess they don't like you to get your hopes up. Mm. We have a great life with her, and I think she doesn't realise she's disabled sometimes. I think she thinks it's the rest of us that have got the problem. I really do. The sky's the limit. I don't think there's anything that she can't do if she doesn't put her mind to it, and she will achieve it. I do believe that.
You've got the best laugh and the best smile.
I know.
We didn't want her just going somewhere and just sitting and watching the world go by. We wanted her to gain skills. We wanted her to be in a social environment, somewhere where she could grow as a person, which is exactly what we wanted. And then all of a sudden we heard about Fighting Chance.
Fighting Chance is a social enterprise which basically which is Brookvale. And what we're doing is we do like internet researching, website mailing, artwork, creative artwork on websites.
So Fighting Chance is a youth-led, not-for-profit organisation for young Australians with physical disabilities. We exist to create opportunities for people who often experience poverty, unemployment and social isolation simply because of their disability.
I know I got a little intense the first day when I got there because I didn't know what to do. But hey, that's what you do. You get there and you get frustrated, but you get through it.
Well, I think Fighting Chance means to Georgia and for people like Georgia that they have the opportunity. They have the opportunity to actually work in a workforce and in businesses and can see the end results of their work. And they are, you know, super productive.
One of the first ideas of the enterprise program was Shags, which is basically bags for your shoes. It's a bit of a cheeky name, but it really grabs people's attention and we thought we'd run with it and it's worked really well.
You know, she has sold over $1,000 worth of shags at one market day, and that is her. That is where she has changed, and that's where Fighting Chance has developed that skill for her. And that's in time, that is something that she could take to any employment, you know, and really build on that. And you know, maybe one day she will leave us and go and sell.
Come on, or ride up, or ride, and people come. One day we had about 40 people come down the shops. I mean, I was so popular that day.
She was one of the first that came on, and the first day she came in, it was just incredible, incredible moment. Her enthusiasm and her confidence has just grown over the last couple of months, and we've been blown away by what she brings to the table.
My ability, it gives me the flexibility to do things more, the flexibility to talk more, the flexibility to be left alone in the house or by myself, and the flexibility to have as much fun as I want to and be sociable and just, you know, have fun.
Hanging out with Georgia is an absolute blast. She's just one of the funniest people I've ever met. When she's singing and she's telling jokes and she's just having a good time, it's just really awesome to be around her.
It's been an absolute pleasure and it always will be. Like I said, do you need me? Are you so in the office? Just bring me up. Georgia, I need you.
Follow the sun.
Which way the wind? One of the things, of course, that's quite exciting about the festival is there's a fair bit of money involved. Over $120,000 worth of prizes for 2015. And I'm going to ask, now I've written it down very carefully. Excuse me one second. Biggest winner on the night was North Cross Intermediate School. And I know that we're going to have a speaker from North Cross Intermediate School who's going to come up and say a few words, but I don't know who that is. Well, fight for it. Hello, are you going to be the speaker? These two young ladies. Okay, well, up you come. Now I'm going to do the introduction, so I better find who's speaking first. You are? And you? Okay, so it's my pleasure now to invite Jennifer and Eason. And Jennifer, are you going to come first?
Together.
Okay, great. It's preparation that's the key.
Hi, we're Jennifer and Ising from North Cross Intermediate. Last term, we helped create a short film about our classmate, Kayla Neild.
Kayla has auriculocondyla syndrome. This means her jaw doesn't grow, and this has led to 30 operations in her lifetime and another upcoming operation this November. Although Kayla has a disability, like many young Kiwis, this does not stop her from achieving her goals.
Our film was based on one simple concept. It was how Kayla could do her daily tasks just as easily as her many peers.
We based it up on how her ability to participate in sports, hobbies, and other school activities.
Our experience with filming, planning, and editing was enjoyable, as well as being educational for both ourselves and Kayla. After entering this competition, we had to advertise our movie to our school and spread the news to our family and friends. We promoted our film in a number of ways, including having it mentioned in the local North Shore Times, speaking at assembly, emailing all students in the school, and utilising social media.
In a few short weeks, we were informed we were finalists and Kayla was invited to the 2015 Focus on Ability Awards in Sydney, Australia. Kayla was so excited that she packed her bags a week before the trip. When the time came, Kayla, her mum, and our teacher, Mrs. Godfrey, were picked up from the airport in a limo and transported to their hotel in style. They then went sightseeing to Madame Tussauds, the Marine Life Aquarium, and the zoo. Once their sightseeing came to an end, the group made their way to the ceremony and got to mingle with other keen contestants.
Kayla was thrilled when they were announced the winner of the most online votes and $10,000 worth of sport equipment. We reacted with joy and we were proud of what we produced. To this day, we still can't believe what has occurred in the past term and we remain grateful to our teacher, team, and all those that voted.
Because without them, we wouldn't be standing here giving you this daunting speech.
Thank you,
and we wish you a good afternoon.
Hang on, ladies. Yeah, no, you do the speech, you get the cash. That's the rules. So hang on, because just a second, a couple of things I should have mentioned before. You may not know it, but you're actually in Ridges. Ridges, what a great hotel chain. Sponsors of the Focus on Ability film competition. If you're planning on using a venue for your wedding, conference, bar mitzvah, whatever, come to Ridges. What a marvellous place it is. And also, Rebel. Rebel Sport. Rebel Sport make the best, sell the best sportswear, sporting goods and stuff that you can possibly get off. If you're thinking of doing anything sporty, and God knows I'm not, you can go to Rebel. And Ryan, what have we got? Here we are. We handed North Cross Intermediate this check at Focus on Ability, but we didn't give them any actual money. Now we've got the actual money. Now Rebel have given it in $250 vouchers. There are, I believe, therefore 40 $250. And we know there's 40, so no getting 39 get back to the school. So who's going to get it? I think these girls should get the cash. Yeah. Come on, ladies. You did the speech. Talked about it, better watch it. What do you think? 'Cause Kayla can.
This is Gemma. She attends North Cross Intermediate. This is Kayla. She's a proud member of North Cross Intermediate.
This is Samara. She is wearing the North Cross uniform. Kayla also wears the North Cross uniform.
These are members of TC1 and they sit at this table. Kayla is also a member of TC1 and sits right here.
Dominique is a biotech monitor and loves to help out.
Kayla is a biotech monitor and loves to help out too.
Here is Rachel. She is a member of the School Gardening Club and helps develop sustainable gardens for school use. Kayla is also a member of the School Gardening Club and loves greenery.
North Cross students attended the Year 8 camp at Finlay Park.
Kayla attended the Year 8 camp at Finlay Park as well.
Hockey is Shannon and Jackie's favourite sport.
Hockey is also Kayla's favourite sport.
And they love playing hockey together.
Sana and Mr.
Mrs. Knott had lots of fun finishing the North Cross Fun Run. Kayla also had lots of fun at the North Cross Fun Run.
Jennifer plays the piano beautifully. Kayla plays the piano with great enthusiasm.
This is Josh. He likes to relax with a book. This is Kayla. She likes to relax with a book too.
And another winner, Carlson School for Cerebral Palsy. I know that they've done a bit of marketing for us with the shirts. That's always appreciated. On behalf of Carlson School, I'd like to invite Faye Philp to come and talk.
Kia ora tātou. Wow, what an amazing event this is. I just want to thank Novo Employment and the people who put this film festival together. Yay. How could we ever imagine that at the very beginning of the year, when our Deputy Principal, Kathy Harry, said, we're going to get involved in this, we're going to make this movie. Yeah, and I went, oh yeah, okay, good. and Kathy talked with our students, she motivated them, they motivated themselves, families got behind it, the rest of the school was going, oh wow, is this really happening? Yeah, and, you know, and natural talent just came. So the film was made. And it was sent in, and Kathy said, well, now we've got to rally all our family and all our friends, and all our networks, because we want votes. Wow. People loved these guys. The enormous shift that I have seen as the principal for these young men, I'm still actually trying to get to grips with articulating. They went from boys to men. They went from young men doing a good class program, learning, having a bit of fun, sometimes being a bit naughty, you know, that's good. Sometimes trying to escape out the front door, miracle, but we won't mention that too much. They went from what was an absolutely fine level to a group of young men who have now been on the international stage. I mean, who would really have imagined that could happen? And through this whole process and through the exposure that's happened for these young men, extraordinary things have happened. For them, they have exceeded their own, their self-image, their confidence, their whole perception of themselves. And I can see it in the families too. And I'll tell you a little story. In wanting to publicise this movie that these youngsters have made, I sent it to an old university professor of mine, not that she's old, but it was a long time ago. And she texted me back and she said, I'm sitting in Vancouver waiting for a ferry to take me to somewhere else, da, da, da. And I'm at the end of my academic career, and when I come back to New Zealand, I want to develop an arts program for dance and drama and arts for people with disabilities. And suddenly I got this on my email. And so what these young men, our Room 5 boys with attitude, demonstrated to someone on the other side of the world, they helped to make that person's dream become working towards fulfillment. So, you know, we can't measure for a single second the remarkable breadth of the influence that this making this movie and achieving that recognition on the world stage that this has had. It's just been remarkable. So I'm exceptionally proud of the young men. Very much an appreciation of our Deputy Principal, Kathy. And I'm sure that, and also, of course, the class team and the families and the whole school community, the Board of Trustees, everyone's got behind this, and we're still talking about it. We're still immensely proud, and who knows what we're going to do next year. So thanks for opening up the possibilities for us. Thanks for giving our boys with attitude and ability a chance to shine, and just keep on doing it. Thanks.
Now, at the risk of breaking up the program, I wonder if I could get your film stars down the front.
Yes.
No limit to the number of times you can enter. We've a number of people who, disappointed by not winning in the first year, are still coming back. We also have people who, Faye said, are incredibly engaged by the changes that participation can bring. Mount Gambier is a town between Adelaide and basically nowhere. And Mount Gambier High School put an entry in, but they wanted to see if they could get them over the line, so they loaded the school into a bus, and teachers, parents and film makers drove from Mount Gambier to Sydney. If you've got a really good car, that'll take you 2 days. If you've got their bus, it'll take you best part of a week. But they made it, and apparently they made it back. And brought themselves along to what is a tremendous celebration of achievement. Thank you very much, Carlson School. Best see it.
Guys, I'm really sorry. I just have to go down and see the principal. Quinn, can you take over? So guys, we're labelling the skeleton. Thank you, Quinn. Oh, and guys, don't forget the bandages.
Huh.
Thank you, Quinn.
Skies.
you?
Key.
A key? What do you want a key for?
Bus.
The school bus? Yes, let me get it for you. Hello, room 5. Quinn's got the keys. Thanks.
Take it. 5. 2. 3.
Focus on our ability.
Yes!
See our ability.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's almost over for me at least. I've just got one more speaker to introduce, but before I go, just a quick thanks to Donna Sheargold, who's over the back and is the organiser and administrator and made sure we got here and this room was available and the whole thing ran fairly smoothly. Ryan Goodwin, who's Nova's Media and Marketing Manager and rejoices in the fact that I frequently say, Ryan will do that, and put together all the films for us and gets them to the judges. Just, I should say, we don't judge the films. The films are judged by a panel of people that are actually in the film and television industry because they're better at it than us. So they don't always get it right, in my view, but they do pick their view of the very best of the 160-odd films that came in. Also, Anne Goyer, transition to work expert, came over to talk about movement from school to work. If you do want to talk to someone that's pretty clued up, Anne's always happy to talk about something that's obviously very close to her heart. And so from me, ladies and gentlemen, again, thanks for coming, and I'll hand over to Ryan.
Hello, everybody. It's very much a pleasure to be here. Donna and myself got to tuck over here a couple of days ago, so we've been out and seen some of the beautiful sights in Auckland. Beautiful city. I wish you well this weekend in the rugby. I won't look past that, but we'll go for this weekend. I'll be cheering both New Zealand and Australia on. It's not often I get nervous, but I'm nervous today. You don't get to speak in front of international film stars too often, so it's very much a pleasure. I've seen you all on the small screen, on the big screen, and now I get to meet you all in person. So that's a big thrill for myself and for our staff, so we're really happy with that. So basically my task from now up until next year is to make sure this competition runs smoothly and we get as many of you back to enter next year, and we get to promote the skills and abilities of people with disability, not just in Australia where we are, but right across New Zealand and right across the world. So we've opened the festival again. We're going to be updating the website sort of towards the end of the year, get some graphics up there. And entries will close next year, June 30. So you've got from now up until June 30 to work on your new ideas. And as we've said, the films don't just get played within your school. They get played, taken up to the internet, and then they get played all around the world. So even the films that don't receive prizes receive international recognition. So I know students and young people especially are all about getting their films viral, and they want to get these viral films. Well, we've given you the tools and the opportunity to do this. So, no, your work is going to get seen right around the world. So I think that's pretty exciting. So my contact details are always up on the website, so you can contact me with any questions I've received over the last 7 years. Every kind of question you can imagine, so don't feel it's too insignificant or too large. I've received many phone calls. I'm happy to take any way of correspondence you choose. So we hope that you've really enjoyed being a part of the festival, and we want to make sure that you're all a part of it again next year. We've got one more film we're going to show today. I'm left with the pronunciation. My pronunciations are terrible. So bear with me. I'm going to get this wrong, so I need someone to yell out how to pronounce it correctly. Otamotai College? Otamotai College. Okay. I promise I'll never get that wrong ever again. So these students have put together a really great film for us to show today. I have to warn, there is a little bit of simulated violence within this film, and it touches on, you know, an important topic, PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder. So it's really important to show both light and shade in terms of, you know, disabilities. So I just wanted to promote that warning. So I believe that the young primary school is just going to step out for a little while and while we play the film. So I've just given anyone else the opportunity that they feel that it might offend at all.
Do you know what it's like to have the earth pulled out from beneath your feet? You can try to deny it, ignore it, say everything is okay, but you know you're falling, and you feel like nothing can stop you. Every day is just downward spiraling into darkness, and you can feel it taking over. Every second of sleep is a nightmare, and every waking thought 10 times the horror. Life goes on around you, but you stay still, stuck in time, trapped by the memory and the fear and the guilt. You distance yourself from those who you love most, and you're isolated by your own mistrust. You can't sleep, you can't eat, you can't look yourself in the mirror and feel anything but broken and worthless. And you hate him for it. You hate him for doing this to you. But more than that, you hate yourself, because you think you let it happen. Some days you wake up and you feel like you're going to die. It's not that you want to kill yourself, it's that you feel like something is going to kill you. Some days you wake up and you feel like you're okay, but then you see someone, something, and you're reminded that you're not, and suddenly you're falling again. Thank you.
Alice, welcome.
Slowly, slowly, things get better. You find there are ways to heal, to recover, to grow. Mountains become molehills and things get easier to deal with. It's never really gone, but some things help you forget, even for a little while. Eventually, your confidence is restored. The people you pushed away return. You can live again.
Yeah, so thank you very much for entering that film. Mental health issues are fast becoming so rampant in today's society, and it's something that I think this statistic that I've seen recently is one in three, I'm going to speak from an Australian's perspective, one in three Australians sometime in their life suffer from mental illness and have mental health issues. And on, from a men's perspective, it's 50%. So 50% of men at some stage will have mental health issues and have that as a disability. So it's really important to recognise that, to have films that, you know, shows some different sides of mental health issues and show that there's other ways that people can seek support. So we really appreciate that side of, you know, the disability being shown, so thank you for that. As we said earlier, three films last year from New Zealand, 14 this year, and we hope to really increase that again next year. So we started off, our first screening in Sydney was to an audience smaller than this. And this year we had a sold out 750 person capacity venue. So this is the kind of evolution the festival takes, and we really hope this evolution happens within New Zealand as well, because I think these films can go to a much larger audience and impact much larger groups of people, because people really need to see all these skills and abilities that are being shown. So I would like to, on behalf of Nova Employment, thank you all very much for attending today. We hope it's not the last time we see you all. Hopefully we see you all again in the coming years, because that's been a great part of the festival. Is I've seen filmmakers and people from schools for the last 7 years, and we get to catch up, and I see the evolution happen as the filmmakers. So we've got tea and coffee up the back there and some juice, so please dig into that. And yeah, we're sticking around to have a bit of a chat. So if anybody needs to leave, feel free to do so. Otherwise, hang around, and it'd be great to meet you all. Thank you for coming.